Hello, everybody, and welcome to Particle Fleet Emergence. This is a Creeper World Chronicle. So it's part of the Creeper World Saga, which is a series of games that I've personally never played, but I've had my eyes on for quite some time. The problem is I never actually got into those games, as in I never paid money to play them, because the screenshots were so scary to me. I wanted to love the game, but couldn't figure out what the hell the game was really about. So I actually never played a Creeper World game. During the winter sale here on Steam, I saw Particle Fleet. Didn't actually know it was a Creeper World Chronicle until I looked more into the store page, and it was very cheap. It was, I think the game's normally $15, and it was on sale for like $3. So I was like, okay, what's this game about? I'm gonna kind of give you guys a little history on my preferences. When I was younger, I played a lot of console games, a lot of PlayStation, a lot of Nintendo. I didn't actually get into PC gaming until 2010, but I did play a lot of computer games when I was younger when I wasn't playing the PlayStation. However, they were almost always real-time strategy games. Command and Conquer, StarCraft, Warcraft, and later in the years, World in Conflict, etc. Company of Heroes, all that kind of stuff. So I adore strategy games, real-time strategy games specifically, but I have recently become more accustomed to the turn-based strategy games as well, and I find those to be just as fun in their own right. I literally am just so attached to the idea of setting up defensive lines of units in games, in real-time strategy games, where, for example, take a game like Company of Heroes. I can have my soldiers set up, and I can have my tanks set up, all in a nice little defensive pit or line, and then have the enemy come at me. And then I can just watch as my defensive line wipes them out and shoots in all the different directions and stuff. Unfortunately, you can't do that in Company of Heroes. You can, but unfortunately the AI in that game is, well, it's one of the types of RTS games where the AI cheats. It knows where you are through fog of war at all times and will constantly utilize long-range units to take down anything that you have set up before they even come across it with normal foot soldiers. So I can't really fulfill my dream in that game. Command and Conquer and StarCraft, yeah, I can set up defensive lines, but they don't really work very well because of the style that those games are. It wasn't until I loaded up Particle Fleet and played the first couple missions that I realized, holy shit, I think I have found a space game that basically catches that dream of mine that I've always wanted, where I can control each unit, they have different turrets on the various ships that do various different things. They're firing in different directions at the different, in this case, I guess, particles. I don't know what the fuck. These red things. I'm not too keen on the story yet. And I can maneuver them how I want. I can make defensive lines. I can create a pincer maneuver on enemies. And because because of the way that the opponent in this game is, it's not like Company of Heroes or something like that. It allows me to be able to form the battlefield my way, while also kind of adapting to the way that these particles, I guess, again, I don't know what they're called, move, and thus my ships maneuver with them. It's one of the first times, because Star Wars Empire at War is the closest game to come to this, where in the space battles, where I can have ships lined up, and I can fight enemy ships lined up. The only difference is that in that game you can't repair ships on the fly. In fact, I don't even think you can repair stuff, period, in the base game at least. And the problem with that is the fact that no matter what, anytime I come into contact with any enemy ships, there's always going to be one torpedo or one rocket that makes it through my shields. And even if it's just one at a time, after a while, I'll lose a turret. I'll lose an engine. And at some point I'll lose my ship. This, it's more like a tide, a red tide, if you will, that overwhelms your ships. And if your ship gets overwhelmed, then it goes down. That's why you make these glorious defensive lines and you strategize with these different types of ships. I've been rambling for too long here, guys. Point is, Particle Fleet may be the game to finally encapsulate that dream of mine that I've had for real-time strategy games. So this is going to be a blind Let's Play. And, well, if this is anything like the Creeper World games, please tell me in the comments section, because I would love to buy the Creeper World games after finishing this if they're anything that are similar. Because I think that this game, from what I've played so far, is gorgeous. There are various different modes here. We're going to be playing through the story for right now, but as you can see, there is Inception, which you need to beat 5 story missions, so I've never seen that. Unlock Anyway, I don't know what that means. Simulchrome? Again, 5 missions, 10 missions to unlock Exchange, Mission Editor, 10 missions, that sounds like a wet dream. And then there's also a Ship Editor, don't know anything about that. There is also this corporation in game where you can actually create your own corporation with its own little image. Unfortunately, I did not buy that DLC, but I might pick it up to be able to gain access to that. So I'm going to go ahead and enter this, and you will see what I have played. So I have only played the first 3 missions. I've unlocked the 4th mission, but have not played it. So everything past mission 3, from this point forward on, is completely blind. And we're going to replay these first 3 missions. They're very, very quick, as you can see. I'm not doing this for best time. I love to take my time in real-time strategy games. That's another thing I do. Supreme Commander 2, for example, you'll see me spend 1 to 2 hours in even the first couple missions in that game. I take my time with these. However, these missions are, well, not that time-consuming, probably because they're the starter missions. And I'm also very shit in the sense that I don't really know how all the mechanics work just yet. But I will let you guys sit through the prologue, and then we'll do the tutorial mission, and then we'll get into the real meat and bones of the game. Give a man a mask, and he will show you his true face. Knucklecracker presents. Now, this, I don't know if this is like an indie developer, like a single person developing this, or if it's a group of developers. I haven't looked into that. Somewhere in redacted space. Prepare to drop out of the rift. I'm not gonna do the voices, because I'll suck at that. Particulate, I guess is what these things are called. I actually get to control the camera here. Jump complete. In Odin's name. So yeah, this is the game right here, basically. But what we're seeing is kind of story stuff here. And that was the prologue. The main story. Now they are... This is totally skippable for me, but I'm going to play it anyway so that I can kind of explain things how it goes. I mean, I'm explaining it like I know, but I'm very new to this game. I've only played maybe a matter of 25 minutes. Oh, I didn't know that sandbox fleet was an option. I don't want to play that. Let's just do the default fleet for right now. Launch mission? Okay. So he's basically going to be taking us through our tutorial here. Or these various people will be. It's a simulator run, so nothing to worry about. So we have our HQ ship, basically. A corporate HQ. Which is kind of our... I call it our capital, our flagship, I guess. Is what you would refer to it as. Simulated energy source. So we can go ahead and jump this in. And it's going to zap this thing, which is going to take control of it, basically. Cap it, if you will. So he's briefed. Yes. Okay. Acquiring and using their energy will be key to our operations. So there are these basically chunks of land, and you can put these things called omnis on them. And the Omni will mire, quote-unquote, the land and use it for energy production. So I can go ahead and plunk like one of these down right here in the middle. And it'll start being built from this thing that we kind of captured. They can be built in space or over land. But they're only operational when they touch down on land. Because you can move these around. So I guess you can build them in space and have them move over. Note the production level from your energy mine and from the land in the top of the left display once the Omni finishes and begins to mire the land. So this is the thing I'm a little confused on. Oh, this is my production level here, I guess. I'm not exactly sure how this whole system up here in the top left works. Yeah, so they also include this thing, this lathe, or lath, which is basically what this... I would call it more a tool than a weapon that is used. It's kind of like a... I don't know what you'd call it. A deconstructor laser, basically. Press cancel to clear your selection. So now we can create a ship, which is, well, the lathe. Or lath. Or I'm going to get the pronunciation on that so wrong. Start constructing the ship. My ship is a remote command bridge engine, the lath weapon thing. Well, it's not a weapon, the tool, I rather, and a laser defense system. So it will be useful for creating energy mines instead of moving our HQ into potentially dangerous locations. So now I can move the ship over here, this one, because it's got that same tool on it. It can go ahead and start working up this thing. Oh, this game is going to be so much fun, guys. I actually wasn't planning to do an LP on this, but I thought maybe, you know. So what she's doing right now is basically telling me that I can angle my ship, I can, you know, rotate it and stuff. So if I hold down E and tell it to go here, it will slide without, otherwise, say for example I do it like this, see how it's going to angle itself. And then the engines will boost up, and then it'll start moving faster. You probably won't see me use that too much unless I'm trying to strafe. we also get to build ourselves a destroyer. Yeah, so these are energy mines, then. That's what these are called. Self-replicating, could be temporarily defeated and pushed back, but would always return. That is a scary thought. Some sort of creature, not necessarily a creature, but some sort of energy source that does that, that always replicates. If it's red, send it to oblivion. Well, there's red on this ship here. Uh-oh. What have we got here? That ain't good. Let's get our ships moving up here. And our ships open up from quite a long distance as well. Yeah, so this is not a combat ship, but it does have a defense. So it's kind of neat if you have two of them together. So I'm gonna get this here to get that captured or built. Oh, that is great. Okay, let's start moving our ships into firing range. This one's only close range, but it might be able to draw some fire. And so what you want to do is there's this thing right here in the middle. The particle emitter is what it's called. And to destroy that, we need to get ships with the lathe. That's what I'm going to call it, is the lathe. I apologize if that's wrong pronunciation. I'll fix that down the road if I can. We need to get ships equipped with the lathe, or we can just move the lathe ship next to it, and it will destroy it. Or work on destroying it, like so. But the closer you get, as you can see... Oh, she don't like it. Pulling her back, because I don't want her to get any damage here. Now this thing continues to shit out these little particulates, I guess is what they're called. But you can see that that we're able to kill them faster than they can shit them out, so we just need to keep doing damage. There you go. Now we've got it under enough control that I can even move this one in, our HQ, to help take it down faster. And bam. That was our tutorial mission completed. Now we get to play a proper mission. Alright, this one isn't too bad, I don't think. Well, of course not. It's basically mission one. So... Jump complete. We went to redacted space. Sensor readings? There's particulate threat here. But there are two emitters. Odd. Energy crystals and what appears to be two tech mods. So those tech mods are going to be very useful. Yeah, so spatial plasma is this blue stuff here, I think. And that slows movement of enemy particulate. But notice that there's also red plasma, I guess. And if your ships move through that, it gets slowed, as far as I can tell. So there's basically good and bad plasma. Okay, now these things here are energy crystals, and I didn't read what these do. Energy crystals are caches of instant energy. Okay, I don't know how important that is right now, but we'll go ahead and bring in our ship here. I'm gonna bring in... bring it in right here. We'll unpause, and the mission has begun. So once this gets set up, I'm gonna go ahead and do this. And we'll get this going. Yeah, so this, I guess, is our energy storage right here. Because each time I get one of those, it spits it up. Incoming enemies. See, I just love that the ship is just doing all these things. It's firing. God, it's so fucking awesome. So what we've just done is we've unlocked an additional lath ship. So now I can actually build two of them instead of one. I'm gonna get this up here to capture that. I say capture, but, you know, I'm kind of tired. That's why I might sound a little bit all over the place. I'm actually gonna bring him down here so that I can get this in to our control. I'm gonna park the destroyer kind of down here in the middle so that little stragglers like this don't get off. Okay, let's go ahead and get an Omni set up here where it wants me to. I'm gonna push our HQ out a little bit further here so that I can cover more ground, because, well, there's a lot of particulates. Okay, so what I want to do is, obviously, I want to get a hold of this chunk of land here. That's why I'm building a second ship. Actually, I can just capture it with this now. Okay, what I'm going to do is I'm going to send this down here. There, okay, now all of our exposed spatial ways here are defended in some way by these ships. I'll move this a little bit forward so that I can get... You'll notice it's shooting at these little red bits. Each time a particulate hits the land, it takes a piece of it, coloring it red. Can't be having that now, can we? That is why we are going to... Oh, right. We need to get this tech here, which will actually allow us to build a second Omni. This in here so that its laser defense can kill stragglers. And... awesome. So now we can build a second Omni, which I'm going to go ahead and immediately put down here. Okay, I'm going to start moving our ships forward a little bit so that I can see if I can capture this in the middle here. So since there are two emitters, we want to try to take down one at a time. So I'm going to first try to take this energy source here in the center. Now, if you capture an energy source and then the particulates hit it, it'll damage it, and then, of course, if it hits it too much, you'll lose it, and you'll have to go back to it, I think. Okay, so let's get a move on this way. See if we can't start working down one of these emitters. This guy should be able to hold his own down here. He can't take too many at once because of his single defense, but a few at a time works. I want to get too close, but I like having this guy in the middle because of his laser defense. Now that is a huge pocket of particulates. Ugh. As long as we keep hitting that big pack of them back there. In fact, I can even move this in and start doing some damage. That'll draw them forward. Okay, time to pull back. Pull them back into this. Kind of like a little mosh pit almost. Oh shit. That is a lot of, here. To park like that. Even this has a laser defense on, I didn't know that. But that allowed me to destroy most of them, so now there's just single particulate stuck there. Let's go ahead and get that chopping away again. There shouldn't be that many left. In fact, get this one in there as well. See, this game is so much fun. If you can actually build your own missions, this is going to be so addicting. This game could have hundreds of hours worth of potential. There aren't many real-time strategy games. In fact, there's hardly any in existence that I've ever played, and I've played quite a few that have a mission editor that is... Well, I haven't played this mission editor, so I can't say how good it is. But there you can see our HQ, how slow it's moving, because it's moving through the plasma. Okay, and now I can get this ship in here to back up. So these missions are easy, and you'll find that you'll start unlocking more tech, like new ships and stuff. I think the next mission we unlock a new ship type, but that's all I played, so I don't know how much more to the game there is. I don't know how many more ship types there are or what the enemy starts doing. Because there's even new types of particulates that get introduced in the next section, or the next mission. Hold them off, guys. Yeah, you're doing it, okay. And now that should be enough. Now we can get three ships in here to work this emitter down. And there it goes. Awesome. God, this game is gonna be so much fun to play. It is only 2 a.m, and I'm deciding to play this fucking game. Yeah, we're going to have answers, and they're probably not going to be great answers. So this is the last mission I played before I stopped and decided to do a Let's Play. So I'm very, very happy that recently find Boner Jams was... good. Great. Yeah, you notice that certain people have beat these missions in 52 seconds. I don't think that's possible, is it? So, that's why leaderboard in Steam games is kind of pointless, because people cheese it. Multiple emitters, what have we got? We got 3 emitters here. Okay, so I want to put the HQ down here. unpause. And the moment we get this up, I want to get a destroyer. Get a destroyer building. Some energy storage, and this. Ooh, what is this? A new blueprint for something. I'll go ahead and get one of these built as well. Because you'll notice that there's actually another emitter down here. And it is a dangerous. Oh, we've unlocked a new ship type. It's got a particle beam and missile launcher on this guy, plus two engines. Yeah, so it's a very fast ship. It's got missiles and a particle beam. So the particle beam, can slow down a particulate, apparently. It can also kill it. But here's what it can do. It can repair decayed blue plasma and destroy red plasma. Oh, by the way, here are the new particulates I was talking about. These ones are, like, intertwined. They're connected. Okay. So. Go ahead and get this one guy moving down here. And get you moving forward a little bit so that you can handle anything else. Just close enough. There we go. Okay. There should be enough defense here. Oh god, it's really spitting them out fast now. But it looks like we're able to hold them back. Oh, but here come the reinforcements. The only thing that's helping my ship here is that blue plasma. So notice how Jesus Christ, that was loud. Notice how they're all stacked up in the plasma. Oh, we took a hit though. But we destroyed it, so. So we actually need to use Omnis to defeat this emitter here. And I'm going to go ahead and build this ship. Because that's going to help us out a lot in this area. Another Omni has been added to our license, and I can build three. I like how it carries over per mission. We're going to go ahead and come over here and take a hold of this energy source. Because we're going to need that. Okay, and with that, I'm going to build... basically, we want to get Omnis built here. I'm going to go ahead and build... Wait, can you build Omnis anywhere? Yeah, okay, that's what I thought. Destroy. So I'm going to build one here and here. And basically how we're going to do this, because this emitter is spreading. So I'm going to build these to combat that spread. And this guy's going to come up here. Notice how fast he fucking moves. I'm going to get him to help us clear out this plasma, as you can see. It's going to slowly clean that out. I'm actually going to get our HQ up here. And I'm going to build the second lathe so that he can help us capture up here. Capture and spread. Moving forward so that you can cut through more of this plasma. So ships can't park on land, but they can fly over it. I found that out. So first things first is I'm going to... Oops, I don't want to do that. You can select all ships. I'm going to focus on this emitter over here, but these two emitters actually. Before I do this. Now notice how this thing is shooting energy at these guys. I don't know why. I feel like it's because these guys have, I don't know, it's like maybe they have their own ammunition storage or whatever. I'm gonna go ahead and build another